Cobra, first thing first, I watched the episode, like I watched all the episodes actually, but of course, elaborately, we are not going to talk about it. But it was such a delicious performance. Can I just use the word delicious? Oh my God. I just loved it, man.
Thank you. Delicious is a good word. I like it. It makes me hungry. And I'm glad you actually use the word delicious because Farah is hungry for blood. Farah, as a character, is hungry for justice. And whatever that means to her personally, I think she's out there to get it. And it makes me really, really happy to know that you've enjoyed what you've watched. And it's very encouraging. So thank you for that.
Getting to see that character who talks in a certain way and comes from a different world, how is that process like? Can you please decode that for me?
I think as an actor, I'm so grateful for this opportunity because it doesn't restrict me to a particular, to a particular ethnicity. It doesn't control my mind in terms of this is how you need to speak. In fact, it gave me more than just lines. It gave me wings to fly with it, simply because it's a character who doesn't represent a known ethnicity. When you look at it in an intergalactic space, when you look at it in a whole different galaxy, Farah as a character could have been from anywhere in the globe. But it just happened that they embarked on this casting process that kind of tickled their imagination, said, why don't we have Farah? And she could be from India. So that's what really started this whole journey. And I'm so grateful to the makers who are visionaries in their own right to give Farah this chance to be from the Indian subcontinent, but more importantly, give me that opportunity even to audition and to try out for it. And I think, as they say, the rest is history. You're right, there is a new language to learn. There was a lot of physical work that went into becoming and transforming into Farah. And I thought that was all so wonderful. So that's that for me. It's true, right? When everything is done, you look back and go like, yeah, that was the greatest thing that ever happened to me. So yeah, this is one of the greatest things that have happened to me.
But tell me, when you just mentioned that, it was a audition process that you went through to back the role. How, as an actor, it kind of boosts your confidence, the fact that you got the role only because of your talent, because you auditioned for it and you backed the role, and that to an international project. And I would like to add one more thing here. When the trailer released, right? Before the first episode that is there, we all can watch that. There was a line in one of the articles covered by an Indian media house that says Kubra has a blink and miss appearance. They now when I like they just don't know how to look at this whole thing of an Indian actor through audition getting a delicious role like that. And then how do you think that this approach needs to be changed also, that like media needs to be a little more responsible or sensitive, maybe. I don't know. As an actor, I want to know that side of the story.
There is this very good old song, Kuch toh log kahenge, logon ka kaam hai kehna. So that is something that is our truth anyway. But it's all right for people to feel what they do when they watch you in the first three episodes or they watch you in the trailer. I mean, it's a trailer. So you need to watch the whole show or watch the whole project when it's done. And we are very quick to react in general, which is humanity as a whole right now. We don't really sit around absorbing or understanding or even feeling things or emotions to its fullest. We are just so quick to react and move on. We barely ever listen. We're only hearing things and like just reacting the whole time. So I think in that sense, it's fair for people to have said, oh, she's got a blink and miss in the trailer, but I'm still in the trailer. Which makes a huge difference to an actor from anywhere in the world. I mean, we've got actors who are from Australia, we've got actors from the United Kingdom, we've got actors from Africa, we've got actors from Ireland, from America on the show. And the whole idea is to be an actor. And then when you see the rest of the show, you understand how beautifully this entire character has been written and has played out. And nothing in this show about a particular character is coincidental. Everything has a reason. And only when you reason and when you experience it as a whole, can you realize that that's a good job or that's a good show. So I would like people to like take that in first and appreciate it for what it is. Because I believe during the lockdown, we have become a very quick to consume population. You know, a whole show drops, people binge it mindlessly. You know, they're watching it with their phones, they're watching it with their food, they're watching it while cooking, they're just watching things. But when Foundation is available on Apple TV Plus and you do access it, I would only say keep your phones away. Enjoy this show because it's an hour long. You will love every episode. And the beauty is that every episode gives you more to think about. And I honestly think the creators, the makers, the producers have had so much confidence in what they've created that they do know people will come back for the next week. So if you are a fan, you will continue to remain a fan. If you aren't a fan, you will become one.
Now, there's a scene, right, in which like you were in the car along with the other character, and she asked, like, tell me your name at least. And you said, "Ki, are we best friend now?" The question that I would like to ask, that, you know, are you guys best friend now with the cast and crew, the entire, because it's a gorgeous, like, so many good actors, like, sharing the screen, like, you know, just tell me more about, like, you know, how was your experience of working with some of this wonderful actors that otherwise also we admire?
I think I'm someone who believes in human connections, and it's not important to really put titles or labels on them to say, this is my best friend, this is my good friend, this is my friend, this is my acquaintance, that is my lover, this is my father, this is my mother. No. I think in general, as human beings, we all shared such a close connection because we were the only family we had for each other. We were shooting during COVID. Everybody was away from their friends, families, familiarity, food, and everything, right? Like, I just love the alliteration as a whole. But the whole point is that we were here leaving everything that we know behind us to create a new bond. We couldn't meet anyone else. We couldn't go anywhere else. We just had to spend that time together. And how we optimized that time, I think for us, strengthened our relationships at a personal level. We were able to, like, let our guards down. We were able to share our personal stories, our personal journeys, hear more about everyone else, or just sit quietly without a word being spoken and enjoy our meals. And I think that for me is greater than, you know, oh, that's my best friend. These are human beings I worked with. Like my colleague you were speaking of, Salvar, Leah Harvey. She's someone who slipped into my DMs on Instagram even before I had the show. And she said, do you need help with the lines? Do you think I can help you out? Do you think you want to discuss your character? And this is her. She's already got the part. She is the lead actor of the show.
Yeah.
She's primary cast. And she reached out to me, who was still in the auditioning process, to ask me if she could help me out. I think that is human. I think that tells you a lot. That speaks a lot. That speaks volumes about the person. And I think that's what you hold on really close to.
And, you know, as we are constantly talking about it, right? Like, you know, whether it is Priyanka Chopra, whether it is you, there are so many people who are actually, like, you know, bagging some of the substantial, important characters in these international projects and really, really re-establishing our presence in the global cinema or in the global entertainment space. How you want to take it forward now? Because this is a huge show. Your character in the show is so huge. I mean, that I'm talking about the narrative and the impact of the character in the story. That was so you know, huge. So I want to know, like, now how you are going to strategize it more, like, you know, or is it now you're only gonna do like those international shows, or mare liye kuch nahi bata, like, you know, for Hindi language it's like, you know, okay, fine, but now I have this. So how you're
strategizing? Of course I have it. Of course it's a reality. It's a reality for me today. I am a part of one of the greatest technology partners we could have ever worked with. You know, time and again, Apple has been a brand that reinvents itself with Apple TV Plus. We've only pushed the envelope a little further. That being said, I am somebody who lives one day at a time, one project at a time. And if my next job requires me to travel to Mars to shoot it, I'll do it. If it requires me to go to Mira Road to shoot it, I'll shoot it. End of story. I'm here to work.
Okay, then. Wish you all the best. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for talking to us. I know there are some very interesting films also you have signed and you're working on, but today is probably not the day that we can talk about all that. But you know, I wish to meet you face to face.
I wish to meet you.
and wish you all the best. And next time, I hope we are sitting face to face and talking about. Yes.
Absolutely. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Arundhati.